I don't know, he just wanted the change. He knew he could beat them with Cloud. Less
Yeah.
effort. I don't know. But yeah, I guess after getting dominated by it, I can sort of see why. So anyway, we're into game one. After a smash of Kibzu versus Plastic Pop Tart and Matsu. Doubles grand finals at that blast zone. Kibzu optic for the Bayonetta. Oh my days, ooh. All right, a Gimp on Robin already. I think that was a down air from Afro. As I said earlier, Afro is really good at like timing those down airs and getting them. Even on recoveries that seem quite impenetrable, like Sonic's.
Yeah, he's had a lot of practice with like Ixis, which is one of the harder recoveries to punish. Which time getting punished there? I haven't seen Kibzu's Bayonetta before.
Yeah, he brings it out occasionally. Like, I think he basically has a Mr. R portfolio. He's got Sheik, Cloud, and Bayon.
Yeah.
Basically the three best characters in the game, to be fair. Apart from Diddy.
Sheik, I feel, up for debate.
Yeah, maybe.
I think she has best results.
When she's played really well, she is just...
Yeah.
Oppressive as hell. And she does have pretty good results. I think, like, those four are probably, like, a cut above the rest of the top tiers. In terms of matchup spread or something, like...
Game evening up again, despite the early start on Maxi.
Yeah. Yeah, so now it's 2-2. Ooh, that back air is not going to kill from across the stage. So, blue team are in a trouble situation, but now they've got stage control. That'll be Robin's stock, so now it's 4-3.
Randy up smash working out.
Is Kibzu going to take his stock?
No,
no. This is the second wish twist. I think Matsu is off to the air dodge there. Ooh, is there going to be an interaction in the top corner? No. Okay. Pop Tart just dies there. So it's 4-2 now. Blue team looking like they're taking control, but that will be it, I think, yeah.
Afro is also at high percent.
Yeah, he is quite a high percent,
it won't be hard to make it back.
If he gets checked, he might be checkmate percent. Oh no, it's too high, I think. Ooh, that neutral had to back it. It's quite sexy. Oh, he was after that down smash or something. Maybe it's too far off of that, but he got interrupted anyway.
Tipper.
I think he waited a bit too long there after it was like,
yeah, but
sort of interrupted
he was ready
the grab
for
there, yeah. Bit too enthusiastic. Always Pop Tart got this edge guard on Afro. Ooh, that F smash didn't quite tip her. That would have definitely been the stock.
Ooh,
Kibzu gets the neutral air.
But Pop Tart's edge guards have been so crisp.
I know. Ah, it's great to watch a good Marth edge guard because he, like, and Marth is so. Oh, that was lovely.
That was nice. Little taunt going on.
Yeah. Yeah, Marth's arrows cover so much space. It's really quite formidable when you're trying to get back on stage.
And his aerial movement is quite fluid.
Yeah. And he's quite floaty, so he just stays in the air.
Yeah.
And hovers with you, and he can just cover that whole area with one tack.
Mm.
Even as Meta Knight, he can be, like... Meta Knight's recovery is really good, but, like, Marth can still beat all of his options.
Yeah.
That massive sword. He's, like, one of the better edge guarders in the game. And his ledge trapping is quite formidable as well. I think that's,
yeah.
like, something that people sleep on a bit with Marth, like, the ledge trap game.
And because... Jab is such a quick move too, and it can lead into F smash.
Yeah.
It's quite scary.
Yeah. And jab F tilt at the ledge as well kills quite early.
Yeah. And it leads into another edge guard.
The jab is just such a like a cash money move. Like, does everything.
Mm.
So safe. Really hard to get around.
We've seen a lot of town and city this.
Yeah.
Top three.
I guess they're just sort of comfortable on it. All of these characters kill off the top fairly often, apart from maybe Marth. And Samus, actually. So, I don't know.
Yeah, Samus' upper is a good move, but that's a kill move.
Yeah,
not too
Samus
often.
Gets quite a lot of her kills off, like,
their back air and charge shots, so.
And they're all horizontal kill moves, so. Okay. The Witch Time going unpunished there. Sometimes it's a bit ambiguous whether you can actually punish Witch Time because of the Bat Within effect.
I mean, either way, Witch Time getting stale is almost a punish in a way.
Yeah.
Because then if they hit it next time, it's not going to do any more damage.
Yeah, that's true.
Damn, that back air almost killed. It was only 103 after the back air, so. But to be fair, Bayonetta does have 100% rage. Wow, okay. Oh, Smash will take it. Air dodges the checkmate.
Afro almost dying off the side there.
Ooh, that was another nice down air from Afro.
He's been picking up a lot of those.
A collateral hitbox. Kids who knows about those collateral hitboxes. Like. Really useful in like one-on-ones with collateral hitboxes. Because you can sort of defend yourself from being punished after a throw. They can't come too close.
They do tend to be longer throws though, once they're collateral.
Yeah.
So if you're aware of the fact that it's collateral, then you can punish it still.
Yeah. Tipper F tilt, taking it from center stage. To be fair, popped out was a ridiculously high percent there. It was like 170.
That nair's so good for edge guarding.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really hard to get past, especially for like Robin. That was a nice, calm, collected recovery from Kibbs there after being stage spiked by Dolphin Slash.
Back air taking Matsu's stock.
Yep. Our back air is like, I mean, most back airs are really good moves, but Samus' back air, for some reason, I'm just so scared of it.
Yeah. It's quite large.
Yeah, it's quite
large. Doesn't seem to have much landing lag.
No. And it's so powerful, too. Oh, the Nosferatu is going on. Punished by Kibbs, even though he was on the other side of the stage.
See, in that situation, I think it was worth doing.
Yeah, probably.
Because Pew Pummel's F-Ro probably is less percent than.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it depends on the difference in percent when you do the Nosferatu, of course, but I can't remember what it was.
Ooh, missing out on the nair.
Yeah, I think. Matsu DI'd that one up to try and throw them off. Ooh, that was nothing. Getting with the very end of that up smash. Oh wait, he's the same teammate, so. There you go. That up smash is really good in doubles. Like, a lot of throws lead into it.
Yeah.
At Albion last year, I think it was Patrick and Badder. They played doubles together. And Patrick would, like, he plays Fox, and he would just use Fox forward throw into a Bayer up smash, and they took, like, half their stocks like that.
Wow.
Because you couldn't really get out of it. They're just keeping stage control, forcing Kibbs to make the first move.
Bayonetta struggling in the 1v2.
All right. Game
a
two
lot of moves
to Copsu. So it's 1-1.
They did bring it back from last game.
Yeah.
It's quite a dominant showing at some points.
So, just to reiterate, Popsu are they're on the loser's side right now, so they have to beat Afro Smash and Kibbsu twice.
That's a hard task.
Yeah.
You need a lot of mental resilience.
Yeah. Doubles is so draining, like, I can't imagine playing, like, 10 games in a row, potentially, in Grand Finals.
Yeah.
Against the same team.
You have to think about so much at once.
Yeah. Staying aware of everything.
This is the best Duck Hunt song, in my opinion.
Which one is it?
I don't even know what it's called. I don't know what many of the songs are called, but it's a jam.
Yeah. There are some bangers on the Smash playlist. At least it's not Swan Lesson.
Swan Lesson has a special place in my heart.
Yeah.
We're in another one of those situations where... Oh, well, I spoke too soon. But Pop-Tart just hadn't been hit, really.
And I was taking quite a lot of damage. Yeah, so it's really even right now in terms of damage. They're playing quite campy, blue team. It's working quite well at the moment. Ooh, that double Thoron! Neither of them die, though. DI'd quite well. Red team have got full stage control right now.
Oh!
Good grief. Okay, two people die, so it's still really even. So there's one on each team. Ooh! Oh, I thought Sean. I thought I saw the shield break animation there. That was a great tipper up smash.
Yeah.
The Leo special.
Kimsy just trying to eat his way through an entire wall there.
Man, that back air. I mean, I've already gone on about it, so I won't say anything.
They Ooh, really need to clean.
That OB kill, that was quite nice. Yeah, red team. They really like keeping their stage control. Matsu just keeping stage control by herself right now. Ooh, that's not going to be it. It wasn't close enough to the ceiling.
After Smash catches them again.
Ooh, full stage charge shot. Matsu was in a commitment right there, so she couldn't avoid it. And that'll be her stock. So red team are actually ahead right now. Ooh, okay. No, that spike was at really low percent, so it didn't really matter. Afro aiming these charge shots really well right now, and Kibzu takes that stock with a Witch Twist off the top. Everyone's on one stock. Afro's the only one at really high percent, but he's sort of sitting in shield.
I guess the plan is to keep Afro alive.
That's a great charge shot, but no, he's still alive. Yeah, keep Afro alive, although Pop-Tart is not taking any damage right now. He's on really low percent compared to everyone else. But that, oh, the neutral air will take it. Ooh. Okay, Afro's got a 2-on-1 situation. Pop-Tart's covering the ledge with Mar. Okay,
yeah, that's
Afro
it.
Afro just sort of dies. Fair enough.
Momentum definitely on Popsy's side at the moment.
So is that... That was game 3?
Yeah, game 3. 2-1.
2-1. Okay, it says 2-0. So I'm not sure if that's actually a bracket reset. And I've not been following it correctly.
I do think it is 2-1.
I'm not sure. Oh well, we're playing another game in any case.
Yeah. Back to Town and City. Town favourite.
Get someone to clarify that at some point.
Yeah. Quite a scramble at the moment.
Yeah. Fairly even. Afro not dying to that edge guard.
Kibzu also changing the Sheik.
Oh yeah, he changed the Sheik, yeah, so... I don't know. Maybe it feels like Popsu dealing with Bayo really well. I think Sheik is Kibzu's main character.
For sure.
And Sheik is really good in doubles just because her frame data and comboing and combo moves are just like really desirable.
Alright, so where we are. Kind of even, I guess. Not really. I don't know. I think red team are sort of in the lead, as it were, but not by much. Afro living quite a high percent right now. Oh wow, that will be it. So yeah, the only bad thing about Sheik really is her ridiculously light weight. After two weight nerfs, she is quite easy to kill.
Yeah. Weight 83 now.
Yeah.
Red team have been quite good at maintaining the lead.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right. Like, once they've got control, they're very good at keeping it. Especially like stage control, edge guard situations. Once they're in an advantage state, they know what to do. That was a lovely double jump air dodge. Oh, to dodge the down air, and that will be Afro's stock. So now it's Afro on one stock versus four stocks versus Fire Emblem. Alright, now we've got a bit of ping pong going on. That's 42% on Afro. Now they're trying to cover him from landing back on the stage. He opts to go for the edge. Yeah, it doesn't look like a good situation for Afro right now. Even the platforms have abandoned him. Oh wow, okay. Well, that's it. He tried to... good effort trying to get a kill. But,
popped out a maximum of 4 stocks remaining.
Yeah.
Quite a dominant game.
So... that's either a bracket reset or they're 1-0 up in the second set, but I don't actually know.
What do you think that Afro Smash and Kimsu need to do?
Sorry?
What do you think Afro Smash and Kimsu need to do?
Well, they've tried a character switch, and I don't think it's worked out that well.
Yeah. I think they're just getting
really
ruled out.
He might change to Cloud. But we will see. No, he's going to stick with Sheik for now. Give Sheik another game. Mm. Prove her worth.
I mean, one thing is that Popstar's edge guarding is so on point.
Yeah.
And Afro Smash, he is getting these really good down airs, but not anywhere on the level as Popstar and Matsu.
Yeah. Yeah, just because like, Popstar and Matsu are just pushing their advantage like way harder, I feel.
Yeah.
Getting the combos, the edge guards, the stage control abuse. Like, I don't know. They just seem like they've got a better game plan. So I'd say they deserve to win 3 games in a row like they have done.
But on neutral, we're going to Smashville.
Yeah, so this is that small stage that we're talking about. Although they don't have Luigi anymore. Still a good stage for Robin, but I mean, it was Red Team's counterpick, so I don't know, maybe they were just after the early kills with Afro's horizontal kill moves.
Well, it would have been neutral. It would have been done by stage striking.
Oh, yes.
I think so.
Okay. Alright, 3 people off stage. All of them make it back alive. Oh, that was a nice tech from Popstar.
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
That was unfortunate.
Popped our edge guard right there. I think he's developed his edge guard game so well using Pit, and now he's got Marth. Like I was saying earlier, like training weight's been taken off.
Yeah.
He's got much more option coverage to work with.
As well as that, Marth buffs. Obviously, quite a while ago now.
Yeah.
But his fair and other edge guards were like nowhere near as strong as they are now.
Yeah. I can't remember exactly what got buffed. I think he got more damage or something on his aerials. I could just be making that up. I'm not going to try and guess. I'll embarrass myself. But yeah, he's definitely... he wasn't in a good place at the start of the game.
The Sheik does seem to be working out alright this game.
Yeah. I think maybe he's had a warm-up game with Sheik and now he's like turning it on. Fairly even. overall on Smashville right now.
On floaty characters, short hop air dodge just seems like such a great option. I don't know, but to be fair, it can be baited quite hard. Like, if you just wait and see them short hop air dodge, it actually lasts for quite a long time, so you can just sort of do whatever you want as soon as they're... Because they just sort of float in the air in front of you, just hitting with whatever.
But, like, say short hop air dodge in there with Samus.
Yeah.
Like, it's a fast move, there's not much landing lag. Your teammate can also be there to back you up once you use it.
Yeah.
And Afro Smash has been getting a lot of mileage out of it.
Man. Yeah, so Sheik died at like 115 to Robin's Gentleman at the edge there. 90% rage, but still, like, that weight.
Those electric aerials.
Comboing two people at once. Three people offstage once again. That up B will kill with the almost max rage that Afro has. I didn't know Samus's short hop down air auto cancelled, but you know, you learn something new every day. And I believe Pop Tart tried to punish it and got jabbed for it, so it's good bait. Oh, the jab to F smash.
That's unfortunate for Red Team.
Damn,
nice
okay.
Tipper.
Yeah. So now it's a similar situation to earlier. Afro trying to deal with two sword characters at once. They've both got stage control. He's going to have to become Super Saiyan to deal with this. He's sort of trying to... I mean, I don't know. He's trying to do safe stuff. But when there are two people to deal with, it's very hard to do anything that's actually safe.
Yeah. Mantu and Pop-Tart have just been shielding right next to each other, and there's nothing you can really do.
Yeah, because, you know, a grab would be a commitment. So, yeah, it makes sense. There you go. And Pop-Tart's going to punish that. Didn't quite get the F-smash there. Man, Afro Shield getting pummeled right now. There you go, the downswing on the fair, that will take it. So that is one or two games in the second set.
That's 1-0 to Pop-Tart and Matsu.
Okay.
For set two. But Afro Smash and Kibsu definitely showing a better performance there.
Yeah.
Nonetheless, okay, switches to Cloud.
Sorry?
Nonetheless, he switches to Cloud.
Despite
the better
game. Yes, he switched to Cloud. All right. He's not happy with the Sheik. He's lost two games of Sheik, so he's going with the best doubles character, bar none. They're onto Battlefield now. Wonder if Kibsu's going to do much platform camping. They're not laughing and joking now. They are quite serious face right now, trying to come back from this. Bracket reset.
There's still a lot of money on the line.
Yeah.
Matsu goes for the weight there. Works out well.
Alright, the cross slash misses. Both of Red Team are off stage right now, but Kibsu manages to come back with that Cloud down there.
Afro gets the tech.
Yep.
And converts it to upbeat upper from Kibsu.
Yep. Kibsu opting to recover high, but he kills his own teammate in the process, Pop-Tart forcing that option. And it didn't work out very well for Red Team. Ooh, that was
nice,
a lovely
snipe.
Oh, okay.
And the shield break.
Oh, okay. So he just lies. Alright, people dying all over the shot right now. Everyone's on two stocks. Red Team slightly behind. But they're doing possibly slightly better than before. Cloud working out. They've got a sword to combat the swords. Wow, that jab is doing work right now. That was a lovely tipper follow-up. Really well timed from Pop-Tart.
I'm surprised that Pop-Tart just up the unit neutral as a getaway option works as much as it does.
It's just like, it's so quick. It's just a good get off me option. I mean, it's high commitment, but if you're certain that they're going to try and do something and that's the only get out card you've got, then, you know, let fly. It's like, it's so quick, it's even a ledge get up mix up, like get up and then immediately up B.
Yeah.
If they're standing in the right place, waiting to grab you or whatever. So, Pop-Tart actually SD's right there. It's been spending so much time off stage that, I mean, eventually you got a SD.
Yeah.
Red team, ooh, on the ropes right now. Kibzu is dead. They're not too far behind though. Robin at like mid-high percent.
Yeah.
See if they can get this stock off and then they'll be even. But they are taking quite a lot of damage. Especially Afro. Afro's got charge shot on deck. Okay, he was waiting for the air dodge I think, but Martha not high enough percent for that up B to kill and wow, that is it. Kibzu is out. And Afro is once again 2-on-1 versus Plastic Pop-Tart and Matsu.
Matsu on 2 stocks.
Yeah, so. This is the jab vortex.
Get booked.
Oh man. Almost styling on him right now. They're just shielding because they know he's not going to want to grab. If he misses the grab, then...
Well, there you go.
Nice. He DI'd that away, I think. So, yeah, that'll be it. That's 2-0. 2 Plastic Pop-Tart and Matsu in this second set of That's doubles grand finals at Dark Blast Zone.
5 games in a row.
5 games in a row that they've won. Yeah. Looking quite dominant now. Oh, my. I think they've given up.
I think Bowie puts it correct. What is that?
What is that?
Yeah. What is that?
Yeah. I mean, I so want them to win right now.
Yeah, it would be amazing.
Yeah. I want to see this Afro Ganon. I really, like, part of me just really hopes that he's actually been working on a Cloud Ganon doubles team. But, you know as well as I do that he's going to get gimped so hard by Pop-Tart right now. We will see. I mean, you know, character like Ganon, he's bad. Ooh, okay.
What was that?
I don't know. He should have just F-tilted him or something. But, like, characters like Ganon, King DDD, the reason why they're so bad is, like, they're so slow and their moves, like, they're not that safe. Whereas in doubles, being slow isn't that, like, isn't that horrible an attribute because you can't really get camped out as such.
Yep.
So, and his kill power is so high that if he follows up on something, then they're just going to die at such a low percent that, you know. In Portsmouth, there's a team of Ness and King DDD, and the kill power on that team is absolutely mental. And it's like teams are just not prepared.
I've seen some good double DDD from Megabit and Pelygod.
Oh, yeah.
And they're just wrecking it.
Yeah.
Like, it can work.
Yeah.
But at this higher level, going for a random Ganon counterpick.
If you've got such high kill power, then there's no way you're like low tier in doubles. Like, kill power is the name of the game in doubles.
That being said, I have seen like Afro Smash down smash like 3 times. And even if he hits someone, he gets hit like straight after anyway.
Yeah, I think this is a fairly troll pick in reality.
Still a nice little combo going on there. I mean, there's only so many tiers you can go up.
Yes. So blue team still have all their stocks. Red team are on 3. It's not looking good. Both Kibzu and Afro are so gimpable. It's not a good situation, really. Again, it's Pop-Tart, the Edgeguard Master.
down. Well, there goes another
stock. There goes Ganon.
I'm assuming he's gonna, yeah, share stock. At least Pop-Tart's lost one. They can say that they took a stock off Pop-Tart with Ganon in doubles.
Yeah, it's almost a win, really. Yeah.
Okay, that'll be it. Afro's
nice
gone.
Work.
Give it to 46.
There
yeah.
it is.
That was a lovely finish. Okay.
Nice set.
Pop-Tart and Matsu. That was a lovely last game. Yeah. Now they're laughing again. Pop-Tart and Matsu take the second set, 3-0. And they win doubles at Dat Blast Zone 19. Lovely display.
It became a bit of a game of counter picks.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how good that was.
Yeah, I think Kibzu was just trying all the top tiers that he's got to deal with Pop-Tsu. Good to see them doing really well.
Yeah. They've got a lot of synergy. The synergy's really good.
Yeah. Righto. So now I think we've got singles.
Yeah, pro
bracket.